Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cuban. In this video, I want to go through domains inside of Microsoft Fabric. You may or may not be familiar with domains, but what these are just a way that you can organize workspaces and data with inside of Microsoft Fabric to relevant groups or processes or what have you. But what this is a way that you can like filter down and find that, you know what? Enough of all this talking. You know, we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So let me give you a quick example. I actually have a domain already created inside of my tenant, which is called finance. And so one thing I can do here is I could go into OneLake catalog and I can actually see by default, you'll see all domains. And I could say, just show me the items that are relevant to the finance domain. And if I only care about finance, then this is all I need to see. This is what I work with day to day. So you can see real quick that this is a way that you can kind of group things together in a meaningful way that's relevant to you or the business. So how do we set up these domains? Well, the Fabric admin is the one that actually has to initially set up the domain, but then they can assign an administrator for that domain. And then that administrator can assign who the contributors are to that domain. So let's head over to our trusty admin portal and we'll go into domains. And with inside of domains, you'll see that I have the finance domain already set up. So let's create a new domain. We'll just call it HR. And then we'll say Patrick is the owner of this. All right, so Patrick is the admin of this domain. So if we go into HR, we don't have anything here yet. So we can assign a workspace. So let's go ahead and assign a workspace. And you'll have different options to assign the workspaces. Could be by workspace name and workspace admin or an entire capacity. I typically find in larger enterprise customers, capacities are usually aligned to like a line of business or a business group with inside of the organization. So that may make sense for a domain to be specific, and maybe it includes multiple capacities. And so any workspace assigned to that capacity just automatically goes into that domain if that's what you want to do. In this case, we'll just do it by name and we'll just type in, I'll just pick a workspace here. So we'll say GitHub demo. And now that's part of the HR. Another cool thing here with domains is I can actually create subdomains. So maybe I've got different areas within HR. So let's say I've got East US and then I've got West US. All right, and then let's go into West US and let's assign another workspace. We'll give it a name, let's do demo, and we'll pick Dataflow's demo. Excellent. All right, so now if I go up a level, we'll actually see we've got our GitHub demo inside of HR. I've got nothing inside of East US, and inside of West US, I've got Dataflow's demo. Before we go back to the OneLake catalog or other areas where you can leverage domains, I want to show you a few more cool settings inside of domains that you could potentially take advantage of and help delegate certain things away from the Fabric admin if you don't want to manage that for everything. So if we're coming to domain settings, first off, you can set up things. So here you can set up an image if you like one of them. It's up to you. You can see the admins. You can define the contributors. In this case, I've just applied it to the entire organization because I trust everyone. Who doesn't trust Patrick? And then you can also set up a default domain. So this could be for a security group or a given user. If they create a workspace, it's going to default to this domain. That can be changed, but it helps to speed things up. Okay, other things we can do here from a domain perspective, there is this idea of delegated tenant settings. In some cases, they could be delegated to a capacity, they could be delegated to a workspace, or you could delegate them to a domain. And these will get updated over time. If it's not there today, it could be there later on. Or you could go to ideas.fabric.microsoft.com and let the product team know that you really want this setting to be able to be delegated. All right, so let's go take a look at what some of these are. So let me go to certification. This is the idea of endorsements. And so whether it's, you know, certified or promoted, things of that nature, scroll down a little bit and we can actually delegate this to domain admins. Let's go ahead and hit apply. And then there's some other settings in here as well. So let's go look at export. So some of the export settings here can be delegated. So like export to Excel, this one does not allow you to delegate those settings. If I come down to, let's say, export reports as image files, you'll actually see that I've got different items here to delegate. So I could delegate to domain admins and I can also delegate to the workspace level. Let's go ahead and delegate this to the domains. Now, if I go back into domains and let's go into HR, for example, if I come into domain settings, now I see a new section here called delegated settings, export and sharing. And we'll see here that for the export reports as image files, I have the ability to control this. I also have the ability to allow this to be delegated down to the workspaces. So it's kind of a layered approach of administration. You've got your Fabric admin, they can delegate to the domain admin, and then the domain admin can further delegate down to the workspace admin. So it just depends on how how much granularity you want to have or how much control you want to have. And then from a certification, we can define who are the users that can actually set a certification on a given item, like a report or whatnot. Okay, so that just goes over the settings. Let's go take a look a little more of how we can actually leverage domains with inside of Microsoft Fabric. So we looked before at the OneLake hub itself, and we know that we're in finance. So now if I go to HR, I can say all of HR and we see everything, or I can filter this down even further and just say West US and get more specific. So that's cool. Another area where we can do this is inside of workspaces, which I like. So here you'll see I've got pinned and then I've got all. It doesn't necessarily show me the domain as part of this, but what I can do is I can filter. So I could say, look, I only want to see the finance domain. And then you'll see that these are grouped by finance and I can choose other items. Maybe I just want West US. I don't want all of HR. I just want the West US piece. Or I can choose all of HR as well. And then we'll see them grouped as part of the domain. This is really nice if I just want to get quickly to what I want. And if your organization is like Guy in a Cube or like at Microsoft, that list can be really huge. I love that we got pinned items, but now with domains, I can make this even cleaner and just see the relevant items that I care about. One other thing I want to call out in terms of domains today, as of the recording of this video, domains do not necessarily propagate security or access. If that is something that you're interested in, where you want to assign a security at a domain level, maybe that trickles down to the workspace, go to ideas.fabric.microsoft.com and let your voice be heard. As of today, that doesn't exist. Another thing I just want to bring up here is just best practices around domains. So when to create them, how to create them. The best thing you can do first and foremost is if you have like a center of excellence or something of that nature with inside of your organization, definitely partner with them, right? So make sure that everything's aligned, and then you can also put out education on these items as well. Also, if you have a like an internal governance or compliance group within your organization, check with them as well, because they may already have things set up or know the best approach of which domains to create and like how it applies within the business. Another thing to look at too, if you're leveraging Microsoft Purview, if you've set up business domains with inside of Microsoft Purview today, those don't necessarily show up from a Microsoft Fabric perspective, but you could also mimic what you've created from a business domain perspective inside of Microsoft Purview and just replicate that on the Microsoft Fabric side. So it may already have been done in terms of what to call these and how to set them up. So definitely take a look at that as well. And then in terms of just structuring these, it could be done in a bunch of different ways. One, it could be a functional structure, right? So this could be based on a business group with inside of your overall corporation. And so it might just be, you know, finance, HR, something like that. Easy peasy. Another approach could be like a product or project structure. So maybe you've got a given project, expands multiple groups, and you just want to group things based on that product or project. A process-based structure may also apply. Maybe it's a standardized or repetitive process that spans multiple groups or multiple things with inside of your organization. Maybe that's a way to set up your domain as well. And then like what you saw, what I did with HR is you could set this up from a regional perspective. Maybe it's East and West or South, or maybe it's country-based if you're an international company. Definitely explore domains, check with your admins if they're not set up today and you'd like to take advantage of these. They may not know they exist, so show them this video as well. Let me know down in the comments below if there's something you wanna see domains leveraged for that aren't there today. I'd love to hear it. And or if you're using them, how did you implement it with inside of your organization, or how did your organization implement it that you can tell? As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.